how to use YouTube timestamps to increase your views and to increase your engagements. And by the end of this video, you're gonna be seeing exactly why is it that once we started utilizing this hack, this strategy across all of our videos, immediately our views across the board started to increase immediately. Hey, this is Peng Joon here, and today I want to be able to share with you what it is that we've been utilizing on our videos so that if you're somebody who wants to be able to, well, for lack of a better word, game the algorithm and get the favor of the algorithm, then this video is going to be one of the most important videos that you will ever watch, because most people are doing it wrong. And I want to be able to share with you how to do it the right way if you want to be able to get more views. The first thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna be showing you why you wanna use timestamps, how do you apply it, but most importantly, what should you be doing if you wanna be doing it the right way. Okay, so I'm gonna go to my screen right now. This first video over here, you can see that I posted it maybe about 3 months back. All right, it's passed over 100,000 views, and the topic was the top 10 best affiliate marketing programs to make recurring passive income. Now, if you take a look at this video, you'll see that on the bar, right, something very common that YouTube has rolled out is that the snippets and the timestamps appear like this. So it's like how do you increase conversion rate, how do you optimize YouTube video, how do you automate social media posts, how do you promote a product. So notice that this actually comes from this. Okay, so take a look at this. If you want to be able to use timestamps, all you got to do is in your description box, all you need to do is just put in the specific time. And when you put in it in this specific format, which is the minute and seconds, dash what it's about, what YouTube will automatically do on their end is they will convert your video to these different chapters. Now, why is this actually important? Here's why. This is important to kind of SEO, which stands for search engine, optimize your content even better so that now YouTube really understands what your video is about. Because when you start doing this, this is how your videos will start getting visibility. So for example, right, you probably noticed that it's very common that whenever we do a search on Google, we get a YouTube result. Now, what many people may not realize is that the number one search engine in the world, which is Google, also owns the number two search engine in the world, which is YouTube. So Google, over a decade ago, bought over YouTube. And we need to understand that Google as a search engine doesn't actually make money. They make money when advertisers pay them to run ads. Therefore, it would be in Google's best interest to actually send people off to YouTube. So what that means is, so for example, this keyword here on how to get verified on Instagram. For quite a while, actually, this video here on how to get verified on Instagram ranks on the first page as the first video when somebody puts in how to get verified on Instagram. And that is why you'll see that this video over here, which is now over 150,000 views, is mainly fueled and is getting views even till today because it ranks on the first page for this keyword. In other words, what you want to be doing is, and you can see, in fact, at that time, timestamps wasn't even rolled out yet at the start of January 2020. But one thing you always want to be doing is to work on getting an edge in optimizing your videos. Now, why is that crucial? Here's why. It is because when you start doing that, you will start seeing that whenever you make a search or do a search, you'll see that on the first page, you see this? This is where it's Google snippets, where sometimes Google kind of gives you this, like before the search result happens, which is what's over here, Google will take either a website, a blog post, or even a YouTube video snippet, and they will post this here as the first thing. So just think of it as like prime real estate space. And when you have timestamps within your video that shows YouTube exactly what those three things, five things, nine things are in your video, now YouTube has a better understanding of what the chapters are within that video so that that specific thing can appear as a Google snippet. So for example, in all of our videos now, so for example, ClickBank tutorial for beginners, if somebody typed in the keywords ClickBank affiliate marketing tutorial, we're currently number one for this keyword. So when you start utilizing snippets, all you gotta do is take a look at this, right? So it'll be like, how to run Facebook ads? What's the sales process? Why do I need to build a sales process? What is Facebook retargeting? How do I track conversions on Facebook ads? Now, this is the next thing that I want to be talking about, which is what you want to be doing and what you shouldn't be doing. Now, a very, very common thing that I start seeing some marketers do where they implement timestamps, but they're doing it incorrectly. Okay, here's the most common thing that people do incorrectly. They start off with things like timestamp 0.00 intro. Now, intro doesn't serve you. It doesn't serve the search engines. It doesn't get you the possibility of featured on Google snippets or help you optimize to rank on the search engines. Why? Because the word intro itself has zero SEO juice, right? Same thing with like section 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That doesn't help you because it is not keyword rich. Okay, I want you to remember those two words, keyword rich. Every time you are creating your timestamps, if you want to get more reach, more views, and increase their retention, then in turn, get YouTube to further push and recommend your videos more, is to have your timestamps to be based on things that people are searching on search engines. So now, whenever we are putting up these timestamps, every single thing in a timestamp is based on a question that we feel people are searching for in the search engines. So rather than saying 0.00 affiliate marketing, we want to make it long tail. And that's another tip that you want to think of. What is a long tail keyword specific rather than broad? Focus on specificity as much as possible. So this would be like how to make passive income online, how to make money with ClickFunnels, how to rank higher in search engines, how to increase your conversion rate, how to set up an e-commerce store, how to optimize a YouTube video. See what I'm doing here? The whole purpose of this is so that hopefully one day this video might be featured on how to, for this very specific keyword, how to optimize YouTube videos or how to automate social media posts, where YouTube and this section, 12 minute and 46 second, might be featured on Google one day because Google now understands the sub chapter of this video. Now, this is one way to get an unfair advantage because this is something that many marketers and content creators are not doing that you must be doing if you want to be able to get more reach as well as more visibility. So that's why if you take a look at all of our videos now that's been rolling out in the last 6 months or so, they all have this, and because of that, this has significantly increased our views because retention is higher and because now we are getting ranked on the search engines as well as on Google snippets because of this one technique. So as always, let me know in the comments below if you love this technique, this little YouTube hack that will help you increase your retention as well as your views. And if this helped you, please smash this like button. It does help our channel out a little bit and push our videos out further. And consider subscribing to the channel if you enjoyed videos like this one and if you want to be notified for future videos. This is Peng Joon here, and I'll see you in the next video.